Connected learning isn't about a particular platform, technology, or a technique, but it's really an approach to learning. It's an approach to trying to understand how learning operates that's fairly agnostic. It's really about saying for each learner, there is a kind of experience that is optimal from a learning perspective and that is keyed to what it means to really thrive and grow up in a digital and networked age. I think right now we're at a critical historical moment for an approach to learning that is about social connectivity, that's about exploration, discovery, inquiry-based learning, that's driven by real-world problems tied to young people's interests and identities. We're seeing a tremendous opportunity in today's networked world around social connectivity, the ability to mobilize relationships and communities and causes, as well as the open ecosystem of information and knowledge exchange. This is an unprecedented opportunity, connecting learning to real-world engagement, about having porous boundaries between the classroom and the community and the home. These ideas of learning and what makes good learning is not new. It's just that we've been handed these tools to suddenly make these forms of progressive, empowered, inquiry-based learning accessible in a much more broad-based way. We're seeing a widening gap between the privileged and less privileged young people and families. Families who are highly educated and wealthy recognize that learning that's focused on interests and enrichment, out-of-school learning, learning that makes productive use of new technologies, that these are the ways that kids are really getting ahead, becoming sort of top-tier learners. And they're going outside of our public infrastructures, whether that's the school or the library, in order to access, pay for, gain this additional advantage. And the tragic thing is that this differentiation, this inequity is expanding at a period when the technology actually allows much broader access, that there's nothing from a resourcing point of view that isn't that is keeping kids from accessing these opportunities online, but young people don't have the institutional, the social, and the educational supports necessarily to find those opportunities. So it's really a question of a failure of will rather than resources, and that's where I think we really will only have ourselves to blame if we don't take hold of this opportunity.